of this video, you will know how to make a basic top pattern and sew it in CLO, easy step by step, from drafting a back and front top patterns, then continue drafting a perfect fitted sleeve with my simple pattern drafting method. I will share with you some tips and tricks, as well as some essential tools to make this top pattern in CLO. To draft a basic top pattern, first I'm going to create this fabric right here, muslin fabric. I'm going to click and then drag it onto this fabric right here. Then I'm going to create a fabric by using this rectangle tool, click on it to select then rectangle. Then I'm going to click one on this page to bring this rectangle window, and I'm going to type in the width of 23.5, then press on the tab key, and I'm going to type in the height of 62, which is the top length. After that, I'm going to click on OK. Next, I'm going to bring this pattern down a little bit by using the transform pattern tool over here. Click on it, then bring it down. I'm going to zoom in. Now I'm going to switch my tool to edit pattern tool here, click on it. Then I'm going to click on this top edge right here, and I'm going to right click and select offset as internal line. I'm going to create 7 internal lines here. Just type in 7. Then distance, I'm going to select individual, and the offset from, I'm going to select selected line. Then I'm going to come down here and expand that offset internal line window just a little bit. Just click on this edge here and then drag until we see from 1 to 7. So the value for number 1 is 1.5. Press the tab key, then 3, then 12, then 14, then 35, then 58. Okay, so 1.5, 3, 12, 14. Okay, this one's supposed to be 21, excuse me. Then this one 35, and this one 58. So before we go any further, I want to show you how I get this data over here. So first of all, this is a guideline that I use to draft this top here, and I will have the links below down there for you. And here this measurement, the top measurement guideline here, I use this measurement chart to draft that top. And for this example, I use this measurement and this formula here. So this is an advanced course. I will use this data, and I have some link about this drafting pattern. If you have any question, please leave a comment below. Now I'm going to come back here and continue drafting the bodice. Okay, so this one is 58, which is the hip length. Next, I'm going to come down here and click on OK. After that, I'm going to create more internal line from the center out. So click one on the center, right click and select offset as internal line. And this time I'm going to need the dots line, then 3 lines over here, and then 2 more. So 4, 6 total. 6 line, then I'm going to individual selected line, perfect. Then I'm going to press on the tab key here. So the first line here, we want it to be 8.25. Then I'm going to press on the tab key. And the next line, we want it 16.75. Then the next line, we want it to be 18. Then I'm going to expand this window by clicking on this corner right here until I see these two arrow headed up here. I'm going to click and drag it down. Okay, and here 18, now I'm going to type in 19. So 19 is the shoulder length, okay? After that, I'm going to type in 22. 22 is a waist circumference, 1/4 of a right circumference. And number 6, gonna be a bust circumference, which is 1/4 of the bust circumference. In this case, is 23.5. After that, I'm going to click on OK to confirm. Okay, this is gonna be awesome, guys. So I need to create another internal line down here for the top hem. To do so, once again, click on this right there, right click, select offset as internal line. Then I'm going to select it just one. Then type in the value to be 0.7. After that, be sure the distance is individual, the offset from a selected line, and click on OK to confirm. So as you can see here, we just selected and created all the internal lines that we need. Now I'm going to convert all these lines into the baseline. To do that, I'm going to click one right there, click right here, just like that, because I want that to be out of the way. But in the meantime, we do need that lines, okay? Now I'm going to right click and then select convert to baseline. Now I'm going to use the internal polygon slash line tool over here in this 2D window and click on it, hover the mouse to the right and select that internal polygon slash line tool. I'm going to begin my drawing from the center on this neckline up to this edge right here to the high shoulder point. Then come down here to this third line over here. Then come over here to this bust line. So right here, this is the bust line right there. Then to this waistline and come down here to this hem line. Okay, so the hem line right there, and I'm going to come down here to this edge right there. Then press return enter on the keyboard to confirm. Okay, it looks pretty cool, but not yet any close to a block looks like. I'm going to expand the 2D window just a little bit. Then down here, let me just zoom out. So this is important here. We are going to switch to curvature tool. Come over here to this edit pattern tool here. Click on it. Hover the mouse to the right and select this add curvature tool here. Then I'm going to click and then drag. Okay, the same right here, except a little different here. So we want to create this curve right here and drag it until we touch this second line right there. So right here, this is the line that we want it to touch, just like that. Then come down here, I'm going to click and then drag it out because I made a mistake here. Instead of have this dot right here onto this waist circumference, I brought it until it hit this shoulder length. We don't want that. So I'm going to switch to the edit pattern tool, click on it, then click on the right here and then drag it out until I see the line over this waist circumference. After that, I'm going to switch back to my curvature tool. Come over here and then select this edit curvature tool once again. I want to curve this bottom like hem as well, just like that. It looks pretty good. Okay, we also need to curve right here, but we have a different tool to use that. We're gonna use smooth curve tool over here. So smooth curve tool, click on it. So I'm going to place that point right there onto that point, and then I'm going to drag it out and then right click at the same time to bring this round corner by length window. And I'm going to click on this link icon here. After that, I'm going to type in right there 1.5. So as you can see on the preview here, we have this 1.5 curve each side. That's what we want. Then I'm going to click on OK. All right, next we are going to trace this back top pattern. However, we are going to check a couple of things here before we are going to do that. I'm going to switch back to my edit pattern tool. Then I'm going to just click one right here and zoom in just a little bit. So I want to click on this handle and then drag it up, and then be sure this is stay kind of along the line with the bust line. And the same here, I'm going to just click just a little bit right here to give it this curve, but it's a perfect curve. That's what we want. I'm going to check right here as well. Let me zoom in. We want this kind of stay along with this next line right there. Okay. And right here, we want to stay a little curved right there. Okay. So now our next curve and an arm. Whole curve looks pretty good. After that, I'm going to trace that as a back pattern. To trace it as a back pattern, I'm going to use the trace tool. However, I have a quicker way to get these internal lines selected. By using the transform pattern tool, click on it. Then just click one on that internal shape right there. We literally select all or almost all the internal shape. All we need to do here, just select one more line right here. So what we need to do, come over here to the trace tool, click on it, then press down shift on the keyboard and click on that center line right there. Then release the shift key, right click and select trace a pattern. Then I'm going to zoom out and I'm going to just set it over here. That is the back bodice is ready. Next, we are going to do the front bodice, okay? So the front bodice is simple, guys. What we are going to do here, I'm going to create two lines here. So switch to edit pattern tool, click on it, then select this edit pattern tool here. Click on this shoulder line. Then I'm going to right click and select offset as internal line. Okay, so to bring this create as internal line window. However, there is some problem here. So instead our internal line go down, it went up. We wanted to have this opposite direction. To do that, we have this under option here. We have to check this box right there, reverse direction, check that box. And now our internal line, instead of go the opposite direction, just came this way. That's what we want. Now I'm going to increase the number of offset to 2. Then I'm going to type in the first value of 1, press on the tab key, and the second value is 1.5. And offset from selected line, distance individual, perfect. Next, I'm going to click on OK to confirm. Okay, so as you can see here, we just created two more internal lines. And next, we are going to use the internal polygon slash line tool over here. So click on it. Then I'm going to select this internal polygon slash line tool. So this is cool. See right here, this is a internal line with 12 centimeter when we created. That is the front next depth right there. Then I'm going to come over here. So the first internal line, that is a high point shoulder. Then we are going to come down here to the second internal line, that is the low point shoulder. So I'm going to click and then place that right there, okay? Next, I'm going to come down here and click on this bust line right there. And I'm going to press return or enter on the keyboard to confirm. All right, let me zoom out. It actually, we almost done, guys. All we need to do here, using this edit curvature tool over here, click on it and then come to this edit curvature tool, click on it to select. I'm going to just click and then drag it down just a little bit. By the way, guys, this is a basic block pattern drafting method for a fitted top, okay? Next, I'm going to click and then drag this to curve it in. You see right here, this is the line that I'm talking about here. We create this shoulder line and then 1 centimeter less than shoulder line. Then this right here is 2.5 left from the shoulder length. This second line right here to create this front block curve. Okay. And I'm going to zoom out just a little bit. So as you can see right here, we create this perfect front bodice block. Okay, it looks great. So next, I'm going to trace that as a front bodice. To do so, once again, come over here to the transform pattern tool, click on it. Then just one click on that, guys. See right there, we just click the whole internal shape that has line connected with one another. Next, I'm going to switch to the trace tool over here and press down shift and continue clicking on this line right here. We want to trace this perfect line right there. Then I'm going to release the shift key. Then hover the mouse onto that yellow highlighted line. Then right click and select trace as pattern. Okay, now I'm going to come over here and place this pattern over here, just like that. After that, I'm going to switch my tool to transform pattern tool. Then I'm going to right click and select flip horizontally. All right, so as you can see here, we just create these front bodice and the back bodice. After that, I'm going to match and alter a couple of things here. So to match the shoulder length together, I'm going to switch my tool back to edit pattern tool here, click on it. Then I'm going to click one right here and press on shift and click one over here. Then I'm going to release the shift key and right click. I'm going to select match up to start. Okay, so I'm going to zoom in just a little bit. And I want to click and then drag in. Then zoom back out. We want to see a couple of things here. Want to just be sure that they're and actually look pretty good. Now I'm going to zoom out and switch to transform pattern tool. And I want to bring it over here, then rotate. I'm going to bring it down here so we get to match it down better. So in this case, to make sure this pattern rotated correctly, I'm going to create a couple guidelines here. Right there. Now I'm going to adjust this pattern accordingly. Okay, looking pretty good. I'm gonna just drag it down. Let me create another guideline up here. Just bring it down here. I'm going to kind of drag it up so it is kind of snapped to the guideline here. Okay, next I'm going to show you how to draft a sleeve for this top. To draft a sleeve here, I'm going to once again refer to this measurement chart. Right here, we have the shoulder length right here, divided by 2, equal 19. So that's going to be the sleeve width. And then the sleeve length over here will be 56 based on a measurement. And I'm going to show you the formula to draft the sleeve. This is the formula that I'm going to use to draft the sleeve. So first up, we are going to create one half of the sleeve. Then step two, we will make a copy and then unfold it. Okay, so the formula, 19. 19 is the shoulder length divided by 2. That is 19. And 11 is where we're going to create the sleeve cap. And here, the internal line we want to create, one is 9.5 and the other one, which is 13, that is the sleeve circumference. And right here we want to create the sleeve hem, which is 0.7 from the bottom up. So it will make a lot of sense when I start drafting. So first of all, I'm going to create a fabric here, 19. And I'm going to press on the tab key and then will be 56. Then I'm going to click on OK. Next, I'm going to grab the edit pattern tool, then click on right here. Right click, select offset as internal line and reduce it to 1. And I'm going to type in 11. After that, Let's just move this out of the way so we can see internal lines go. Okay, so by default, this reverse direction box is checked. We want to uncheck that. As you can see, internal line went the other way. We don't want that. We want it come down here. So I'm going to click this box right here to uncheck. Now you can see this internal line came to this opposite direction, and that's what we want. I'm going to click on OK to confirm. Next, we want to create two more internal lines right here. So right click, offset as internal line, and I'm going to create two. So the first internal line will be 9.5. Then the tab key, this is gonna be 13. So 13 is a wrist circumference, and 9.5 is just part of the formula to create the perfect sleeve cap curve, okay? So be sure the distance is individual. The offset from is selected line. After that, I'm going to click on OK. Okay, we're almost done. We need to create one more internal line from here. So click on it, right click, select offset as internal line. Then this time instead of 2, we're going to change to 1. And I'm going to type in the value of 0.7. And after that, be sure the option reverse direction box is unchecked. Then click on OK. Okay, let me zoom in a little closer so we can see it better. Next, I'm going to use the internal polygon shaft line tool. I'm going to begin clicking one right here, then click one over here, and then come down here. Just zoom it in, click one right here on this top right there, okay? See right here, that's the one we want. Then I'm going to come down here, and then we want to click this one on this edge of the fabric right there. Then I'm going to press return enter on the keyboard to confirm. Okay, so by the way, guys, this drafting pattern method also works with hand drafting. Instead of using this fancy tool in CLO, we would use marker or a tailor chalk to draw a line. However, with technology, we get to use this fancy tool to create any pattern to draw any line we want much easier. However, we have to know this tool. If you already know the tool, perfect. All right, so get back to a pattern drafting. We are going to switch a tool to this edit curvature tool. Come over here to this 2D toolbar and select this edit pattern tool here and come to this edit curvature tool. Click on it. I'm going to click on that line right there and then drag it up just like that. It's quite clunky right now, but we will make it better, I promise. So I'm going to zoom down here a little bit. You want to curve this a little bit too. Just a little bit. After that, I'm going to do the same over here. Click on that line. Then I'm going to click on this handle and then drag it down until it's level up to the line over here as well as it's in it from this wrist circumference. After that, I'm going to come over here and click on this handle and then click to the right until it reaches this line right here and level with the fabric edge. So as you can see right here, we just create this perfect sleeve cap curve on the sleeve. I'm going to click one on the page to deselect. Now I'm going to trace this as a pattern. To do so, I have a quick way to trace this pattern shape right here. So I just need to come over here to the transform pattern tool, click on it, then click on that. You see one click, we select all this internal shape. It's really cool. Then I'm going to switch back to the trace tool, then press on the shift key on the keyboard and then click one right here to select the last line that we want to trace. Then I'm going to release the shift key and then right click and then select trace as a pattern. Okay, now I'm going to zoom out here and I want to place it maybe somewhat in here, rather, okay? After that, I'm going to unfold that sleeve. To unfold the sleeve, I'm going to switch to this edit pattern tool, click on it, Then come back and click on that right there, that center line, right click, and select unfold asymmetric adding pattern. Okay, so I'm going to check a couple things here. I'm going to create a guideline. Just bring it down here and I want to pull it in. So this is what we want here. Do you see this handle? We want that kind of right below. Instead of up out here, we want it down here, okay? So either level with the guideline or right down a little below the guideline, that will be fine. All right, so next we are going to check the sleeve and the sleeve cap measurement. To do so, I'm going to click one right here. Then come down here, as you can see, we have 44.95. After that, I'm going to come over here and click one on this armhole. Then come over here to this front, click on it, and right here is 44.66. So the sleeve cap is a little bit bigger than the armhole itself, but that's okay because we want the sleeve cap a little bit loose fitted to the armhole. Next, I'm going to click one on the page to these legs. After that, I'm going to create notches for the back sleeve as well as for the back bodice and notches for the front bodice and the back sleeve. To do that, I'm going to come over here to this notch tool, click on it. Then I'm going to hover the mouse over this line right here and then right click and I'm going to type in, you see this yellow box right here, I'm going to type in 9. And that over here is a pier that's 9 centimeters from the bottom up. That's what we want. After that, I'm going to click on OK to confirm. Then I'm going to create another notch right here. So again, hover the mouse anywhere on this line right there, right click. Then move this notch window over here out of the way so we can see this preview over here. And this time, as you can see right here, the yellow line appear from the top. We do not want that. We want to create the notches from the bottom up. So to do that, instead of type in the value in the yellow box, we want to type in the value in this blue box. Now I'm going to highlight it and then type in 11. So as you can see right here, this is the value we want. The bottom up here to the point is 11 centimeter. After that, I'm going to click on OK to confirm. Next, I'm going to create the notch right here. Once again, pay attention to this yellow line or blue line. However, we want to create the notch from the bottom. So always pay attention to the bottom. This case right now, it is yellow. So I'm going to type in 9. Then click on OK to confirm. I'm going to do the same over here. However, I do not want to create notches on both sides. I only want to create it on the back side of the sleeve. So before I can create another notches, I'm going to remove the link first. To do that, I'm going to grab the transform pattern tool, then click on the sleeve, right click, and select remove link editing, okay? Now I'm going to click one on the page to these legs. After that, I'm going to grab this notch tool once again, click on it, then hover the mouse over that line that I'm going to place the notch on, right click, and bring this notch window out of the way a little bit. And I'm going to type in this blue box right here, 11. So as you can see right here, the measurement appear is 11 from the bottom up. That's what we want. Next, I'm going to click on OK to confirm. So as you can see right here, the back bodice have 2 notches. Also, the back sleeve has 2 notches. And we can assume that the front sleeve will have 1 notch and also the front bodice. So I'm going to click right here, right click, right that, and type in 9 centimeter. And I'm going to click on OK to confirm. Okay, so let me remove these guidelines here. To remove the guideline, once again, be sure we are on this transform pattern tool or edit pattern tool here. And I'm going to right click and then unlock all guideline. Then I'm going to just hover the mouse and you see this four-headed arrow appear. Then I'm going to right click on it and then select delete all guidelines. Okay. Now, as you can see, we just created this perfect back bodice, front bodice with a perfect sleeve. Next, I want to sew this one half of the pattern. So when we create copy, we don't have to do a lot of work. Okay. So next, I'm going to move this pattern up here a little bit. So click on that transform pattern tool, click on here, remove it up here. Then I'm going to drag them and then arrange them a little bit. After that, I'm going to come over here to this 3D toolbar and click on the reset all patterns icon. Now the pattern is set to mirror the one that in the 2D window. After that, I'm going to marquee select both of these pattern here and right click. I want to freeze these. So when we simulate and do whatever to this pattern right here, it doesn't affect those patterns, okay? So after that, I'm going to zoom in a little bit in this 3D window. I want to come over here to this 2D window and then zoom in all the way. So we are going to use two sewing tool here. So the sewing tool over here is segment sewing. I'm going to sew the sleeve together as well as the back and front bodice. Then I'm going to use the free sewing tool for the sleeve. Okay, so this is the free sewing tool here. Begin, click one to sew, then click once again to end. Then I'm going to click right here and press down shift and just hover the mouse over here. Okay, click and then continue pressing down shift, click, and then until you see this point right here, click and then release the shift key. So now we just sew this sleeve to the bodice. After that, I'm going to sew the shoulder roughly, okay? All right. Next, we are going to place these pattern pieces onto the avatar. So let me zoom in a little bit. Then I'm going to come over here to this avatar icon and click on the show arrangement point tool right there. And as you can see, the avatar just have this a bunch of point on it. Then I'm going to come over here and switch my tool to transform pattern tool. And I'm going to click one right here on this front bodice and come over here. Let me press number two. We want to have the perfect front view, okay? Then I'm going to hover the mouse over that avatar and you see the silhouette appear. Click on it to place the pattern. Then I'm going to press on number eight here. I want to place this back bodice. Click on it and then come over here. Then just hover the mouse over and then click to place the next one. Then I'm going to rotate her over here so we can see the sleeve better. And I'm going to once again click on it and then place the sleeve right there. So next I'm going to come over here to the avatar icon and then click on that show arrangement point icon once again to hide the show arrangement point. Now I'm going to adjust a couple of things here. I want to click and then bring the sleeve down just a little bit. And then let me see. I want to bring this out just a little bit. Then number two to see the front. Number eight. And then rotate her just a little. It looks pretty good. So now I'm going to zoom out just a little bit. And I want to marquee select all these pattern pieces. Then I'm going to create a symmetric pattern copy. So right click and then select, see right here, Symmetric pattern with sewing. After that, I'm going to press down shift and then left click to place the patterns. Okay. Now, as you can see right here, by default, a pattern is selected. So I'm going to just zoom in and then click on that square right there and just drag it in. We're almost there, guys. We are going to press on number 8 to see the back view. And then drag it in a little more. And then I'm going to press on number 2 to see the front view. And I'm going to, okay, we kind of drag in a little too far here. All right, let's just click one on the page to deselect. We are going to bring it in a little bit different here. So just the back. And then right here, just the sleeve itself. So it is important to arrange them appropriately. So when we simulate, it doesn't all clunky and have this weird effect. Okay, so now I'm going to my key, select all the pattern pieces, right click, and I'm going to strengthen. Okay, let me adjust it over here just a little bit. So now I'm going to click one on the page to deselect. Before we are going to simulate, we want to sew the back and the front bodice. So I'm going to use the segment sewing tool here, click on it. Then just click one here, sew the front with the front and then the back with the back. Just like that. Now we are safe to simulate. I'm going to press on the spacebar to simulate. So now I'm going to press on the spacebar one again to stop the simulation. And I'm going to switch my tool to transform pattern tool. And I want to my key select all these pattern pieces, right click, and unstrengthen. As you can see, we just create this perfect basic top pattern in CLO 3D, quick and easy. I hope you guys find this video useful, and remember to sub and click on the bell for more awesome pattern videos. Thank you!